Hello and welcome everyone. Let's take a look on another set of questions. So in this video, the first question we will talk about the singleton design pattern. So first of all, what is singleton? There are two important points in the traditional definition of singleton is there should be only one instance allowed for a class, and we should allow only global point of access to that single instance. So singleton means whenever you are trying to get the object of that class should maintain only a single object, and whenever you are trying to get it, it should return that single copy of instance. It should not create every time a new object whenever you are requesting it. So it should maintain one global object, and it should return it every time whenever there is a request of that particular object. So we can take a look on to that code. Let me just open this particular link. So here is that particular code we have written. So here in this object, I am adding a singleton property, which is just a function expression. And what it is doing, this is the complete function, okay? And in this, I have written a function constructor. And in the function constructor, I might be having some private methods and all. And what this function is returning, this function is returning one public method and one attribute. Okay, so this is the functions, and through this singleton design pattern, I will maintain a single object of this particular constructor function throughout the lifecycle. Okay, so this function, what it is returning a get instance method, and that get instance method is checking if singleton instance is not equal to null, then create a single object. So it is calling the constructor, and it will give you one object about it. Because what this function is returning, this function is returning this object. So this line will give you an object definition. Now, whenever, because now singleton instance is initialized to that object. So whenever you request another object, then it will check if singleton instance is not equal to null, then directly return the singleton instance without creating or without calling a constructor function. So this is actually the best example of how we write a singleton object. How we write a function which return a singleton object every time. I mean, it is maintaining a single copy. So what we did, we just created a function which is returning another object, and from the return of the outer function, we are returning the get instance method and checking if instance is there. If instance is not there, then create it, otherwise return the existing instance. Okay, another thing is, what are the different ways of creating an object? So there are different ways. Either you can use a constructor function with the new keyword, you can create an object using object literal, you can create an object, or using new object, you can create an object. Using object.create, you can create an object. So this is the first one, is using constructor function, and with the new keyword, I'm creating the object. Another is using object literal. So here I'm defining some properties, some methods. So it is also another example of creating an object. Another is using the capital O object function. New object, and I got the employee object now. Okay. How to write a function for doing a deep clone? So here we are talking about deep cloning one object into another object so that the reference are not shared. So deep clone means a deep copy. And deep copy can be done. There are different ways of doing it, using object.create, object.assign, or what you can do, you can iterate on one object and iterate to all the properties and assign those properties to another object. Same I did here. This is a new object. I have created a deep clone function. I'm passing an object and I'm iterating each and every property of this object for using foreign loop. And if type of that key is an object, then again call the deep clone. Otherwise, just assign the key to the new object from the previous object. Okay, object key is assigned to new object. So here I need to add a check. Consider that a case is where whatever the property is again an object, right? There may be a nested object. So while doing a copy, you need to copy each and every nested property, right? So if the type of that property is an object again, then write call this method recursively. New object dot key, pass the deep clone object dot key. Okay. So this is the way you can copy a particular object into another object, and this is also an example of deep clone. Deep clone you can do using json.stringify the object 1 and assign that to the object 2 by doing a json.parse whatever the string you received using stringify the object. So they will not share the references with each other, and object.assign is there. Okay. When function called a clone which takes an object and create an object copy or but not copy the deep properties of an object. Okay, so we have already fixed this particular problem is whenever you have a nested object, I mean in the object you have another object like the student object is having the address object which is further having properties. So in this case you need to write a code properly. In this code, what I'm doing, I'm iterating on to the properties of object and assigning those properties to the new object. But this particular code will not work whenever you have a nested properties. In that case, you need to add this particular call also. If type of that object key is equal to object, then do call this recursive function. Call this function again in the recursive manner and assign that key property. Okay. So what are the promises and how they are useful? So promise object, promise async await, callback, all these are actually the different ways of dealing with asynchronous behavior in JavaScript. Okay. So promises are actually another way to write the asynchronous code where you need to wait for the execution happens, right? So in the ES6 we have a native promises, and promises object has this dot then method and dot catch method. Dot then method of the promises will get execute once you have the promise either resolved or rejected. So promises are used whenever you are reading something from the disk, from the file or from the network, anything asynchronous. And once that asynchronous task is over, you can execute promise object dot then, which accepting the two callback function. One is success callback and one is error callback. Okay, if your operation is successful, then you can execute the first callback. I mean, a JavaScript everywhere is either callback, either promises, everything is a promises. Okay. Actually, this particular piece of code, most of the interview ask like, what should be the output? I already fixed this particular problem is in the outer function you are actually running a synchronous loop. So whenever you do the console.log in the set timeout, you will get only the last value, which is 2222 four times. Okay. Because the synchronous code has already reached to its last index. Meanwhile, you are still in the halfway for executing set timeout, because set timeout is a synchronous operation. And this operation will be pushed to the event loop and all these things will happen, right? So, but you can fix this by passing, by doing immediately invoking function for the set timeout. So here I'm passing the j value of j for each and every iteration, and this will get printed, each and every value will get printed in the 3 second gap. Okay, otherwise you can just remove this var keyword with the let keyword. This will also fix that problem where we are getting the same value from the array. Okay, another example are these particular scenarios. Type of object, okay, this will be object. Type of array is always an object. Type of new array, this is you are creating an object of array. Type of null is an object. Type of date is an object. New date is an object. Okay, so type of operator gives you the type. Type of string will be a string, type of function will be a function, but type of all different kind of object will be object. Okay, object based inheritance. how you can inherit the properties of one object into another object using object.create method we have. So this is the employee object, and I wanted to create employee one object from the employee object. I wanted to create employee one object which is having all the properties defined in the employee object. So I can do object.create. So it will create another object having all the properties in the parent object. So another thing is how we can prevent the object modification. I mean, how we can freeze the object so you cannot add a new properties and all. So there is a freeze method is there, using which you will not be able to add a new property, object.seal, object.freeze, and object.prevent extension. So you will not be able to add a new properties or modify properties whenever you do object.freeze. That's it in this particular video. Let's connect in the next video for more updates on JavaScript interview questions.